Good morning, students. Today in our class of biology tutorial, we are going to discuss about vertebrata. Students, earlier we have discussed that vertebrata is the subphylum of phylum chordates, and chordates are showing a feature of presence of nerve cord or notochord inside their body. So vertebrata is also a subphylum of those chordates, which possesses, that is their basic feature, that they possesses notochord during embryonic stage. But this notochord is replaced by a kind of cartilaginous soft bone or a bony vertebral column in adult stage. Means that in earlier stage, just like cephalochordates and urochordates, they also have the presence of notochord and nerve cord inside their body. But when they become adult, that notochord is replaced by a bony structure. In some organism, it is a hard bony structure, or in some organism like fishes, they are of soft bony structure, that is called to be cartilaginous bony structure, and they are called vertebral column. We all are having at the back a vertebral column inside our body that is found in the adult stage. But when we are embryo inside the mother's body and growing, that vertebral column was not there. It is simply notochord inside it. So this is the main basic feature about the vertebrate. It make it different from the other phyla, other subphylum of chordates like cephalochordates and urochordates. So please pay attention on this point. It is a major for asking questions in your board exams. Now, second, other features which are exerted by the vertebrates are, they have a muscular body organ which is ventrally present inside them, that is heart. So this heart is of 2, 3, or 4 chambers depending on different classes of organism, and about them we will discuss in detail later in our later other biology tutorial classes. So they have a muscular organ for pumping of blood, that is heart. Say next feature is, they all are possessing kidney inside them for excretion and regulation of osmoregulation. Osmoregulation to make balance with the humidity and salt concentrations in the animals. So that is also found in all the vertebrates. Next feature is, they all are having an organ for locomotion. So they may, some of them are having the paired appendages, maybe fins or wings, and many of them are having limbs for locomotion. So these are the features which are found in the vertebrates. Now let's discuss the division of vertebrates in agnathostomata and gnathostomata. Friend, many times we have discussed that A in biology always stand for absent. So they and gnatha word stand for the jaw. The jaw which held the teeth inside it. So here agnatha is a group in which they don't have the jaws. So they are called to be lack of jaws inside them. Whereas gnathostomata is the division in which they bear jaws. They have the presence of jaws which have the teeth inside them. So on the basis of the presence and absence of jaws, the vertebrata is further divided into agnatho and gnathostomata. Now let's see first about the gnathostomata. They have the class as cyclostomata. Student, cyclostomata, this is the kind of organism which are marine, and they migrate for spawning purpose into the fresh water. So they only come for giving birth to their young ones in the fresh water, and after that when they return back to the marine water they die. So their life cycle is only inside the marine water, and their larvae are growing as a result of metamorphosis into the fresh water, and then they goes back into the ocean. So their examples are these hagfish or petromyzon or myxin. These all are such kind of organism, a kind of fisheries which do not bear any jaws, and they are living in marine water. But their main feature is they come in fresh water only for breeding, after which they die. So their body is having a kind of devoid scales with the paired fins, and cranium are also found with the presence of vertebral column inside them. So students, they also have the gills for respiration, and one more property they have is how they get their food. They have a sucking kind of circular mouth, so they stick with the organisms or prey and suck the fluid from them. Now let's discuss about the gnathostomata, which bears jaws. So these gnathostomata are further divided into super class as pisces, belongs to fisheries, and tetrapoda. Tetrapoda, word tetra means four and poda means legs. So these are the organisms which are having four legs or four limbs inside them. Now let's see first about the super class pisces, which is further divided into on the basis of which kind of bony structure present inside their body, as a chondrocytes or osteocytes. Different chondrocytes are those pisces which are having cartilaginous bony structure. Cartilaginous means that very very soft bone inside their body, and osteocytes have a hard bony structure, the normal fishes. About this class of Pisces we will discuss later in detail. Now let's see the tetrapoda as a super class which bears four limbs inside their body. Their four limbs are, first one is the first class in which they are divided as amphibians, which are able to survive on both the habitat, land as well as water. Second, next one is reptilia. Reptilia are not having a kind, many of them are not having a limb. Some of them are crawling or creeping also, like snake. But other reptilia like tortoise or turtle, crocodile, salamander, these all are having limbs for locomotion. Another class is apes. Apes are having a characteristic feature of flying. They can fly. So their four limbs, first two limbs are differentiated into wings, which allow them to fly in air. And the fourth one class is mammals, that we human being also belong to it, which have the characteristic that they give birth to their young ones and provide feeding, breastfeeding to them. Along with that, they are also having four limbs, like cow, buffalo, tiger. They are using the four limbs for locomotion. But in human being, they become advanced and they use the first four limb for grasping of things. So friends, this is all about the class vertebrata. About the subphylum of chordate vertebrata, its basic features and its division. So go through the topic and pay attention over its division, how are they gets divided. This is all about today's tutorial class. Thank you and have a nice day.